Now, let's discuss another symmetric encryption algorithm, the Advanced Encryption Standard, or AES. Recall that a major shortcoming of DES is that the key length is only 56-bit, and that is considered to be short. In other words, the key space is relatively small, and an attacker can use brute force to find the key using the power of today's computers. Of course, we can use triple DES to increase the key length, but that would mean running DES 3 times, and that's not the most efficient way of doing encryption. Therefore, there was a need for a new encryption algorithm that can take longer key length but also be efficient. So in 1997, NIST put out a public call for a new encryption standard to replace DES. After a few rounds of submissions and reviews, AES was finalized, and it became a new standard replacing DES. Like DES, AES is also a block cipher, whereas in DES, the input plaintext block is 64-bit. In AES, it is 128-bit. In DES, the key length is only 56-bit. In AES, it can be 128, 192, or 256-bit. These key lengths are considered long enough to defeat brute force attempt to search for the key. Here is a high-level view of AES. The encryption process is as follows. Again, the plaintext block is represented as a square matrix. We call it a state array. And we first XOR with a key. Again, the key is also represented as a square matrix. Then the state array goes through multiple rounds of encryption. At each round, it goes through several operations that represent substitution and permutation. And also, the parameter key is XOR to the state array. The operations at each round include substitute bytes. This involves using a table referred to as a S-box to perform byte-to-byte substitution of the block. Shift rows is a simple permutation that is performed row by row. Mixed columns is a substitution that alters each byte in a column as a function of all the bytes in the column. And then the result is XORed with the parameter key. The operations of the last round include substitute bytes, shift rows, and add parameter key. And the result is the ciphertext. In AES, the decryption process runs the algorithm in the reverse direction. This means that each of these operations must be reversible. Let's take a look. Now, adding round key involves the XOR operation, and the XOR operation by itself is reversible. The other operations, meaning substitute bytes, shift rows, and mixed columns, an inverse function is used in a decryption algorithm. By using this inverse function, we can reverse the action of substitute bytes that was performed in encryption. Likewise, we can reverse the effects of shift rows and mixed columns in the decryption process. Therefore, each of the operations are reversible. As a result, when we run the algorithm in the reverse order, we can decrypt the ciphertext back into the plaintext.